sky is above you, the earth is under you, and everything is created now to serve you. ومن كل شيء خلقنا زوجين لعلكم تذكرون. And from everything, ومن كل شيء, and from everything, we created pair. So you might remember. So you may remember. You may reflect. Meaning everything around us, look around, look at yourself, look at everything, it is created in pair. There is an increasing number of things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created on earth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala initiated the creation and then repeats it. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, So run to Allah. Here is everything, here is for you. The heavens above you is built and it is to serve you, and the earth here is to serve you, and created you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us in such fashion that we function in a beautiful way in this life. Now run to Allah. Allah is the only one to run to. Running to Allah has its conditions. And it has, some of us can run, is running to Allah with needs adjustment. And some of us will try to find out how to run to Allah, how to go to Allah. In Ramadan, we know how to go to Allah, right? We know how to forget about things that we are attached to. We learn how to do that in Ramadan. We learn how to leave our homes and come for i'tikaf with the masjid, for example. Or stay up late praying taraweeh. Or coming for tahajjud and praying more. Holding on with the food and drink and so forth and relationship. And on. We know how to run to Allah in this month. So we know what to get rid of. But now when we run into Allah after Ramadan, we tend to go back to things that we were attached to. Right? See, it is time to make a resolution now, or make a preparation now, for how we're going to run to Allah after Ramadan, or how to continue running to Allah. We have a momentum now. We have a momentum. Okay? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the tool with which we are using, and we get in momentum. We should not leave this momentum and run with it, and run or without it. Run in this momentum without the things that we used to be attached to. See, we cannot help but to go to that which we were attached to. We have to go back to home, we have to go back to our work, we have to go back to the children, we have to go back to many things that we are attached to. But now we learned how to be detached from it. So let us not attach ourselves to it again. Meaning, there is a means that we take, but the heart is with Allah. Okay? Before Ramadan, our heart was connected because of the whole year and forgetfulness and ghafla, connected with things away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Ramadan, we detach, let us say, stay detached, but connect with it physically because things that you have to do. We are created to dwell on earth and do good on earth in things that we take the means in and move on. But we can get our heart stay away as it is now, away from that which it used to be attached to. That's number one. Number one is go ahead and we go back to our daily lives, but our heart is connected with Allah. We cannot run to Allah with package or baggages. We cannot run to Allah with things that is attached to us or we attach to it. Because Allah is the only one. He is only one. And you run into that one that everything that in this life belongs to. And everything in this life, whatever Allah wishes to give us, will give us. Whatever Allah wishes to take away from us, will take away from us. So why should we be attached to something that if Allah wills, it will be detached from us by force anyway? Anything that we have, two things will happen. One of two things will happen to it. Either it will leave us or we will leave choice. Okay? So let us leave it, but use it. Use it, not to be attached to it. Not necessarily you are using something that means it is attached to you. This dunya, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala encourages us to use it. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam encourages us to use it. This dunya is the fertile ground for the hereafter. This dunya is the ground that we put the seeds in it and waiting to harvest it in the hereafter. So it is a land that or a dunya that we need to work in and work with and use. But use it, and once we use it, it will serve us properly. It will serve us. But once we let it use us, or once we get attached to it, it will abuse us. Once we attach this dunya, it will abuse us. We will not be able to run to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala anymore. We'll be heavy on to the ground, and we'll not be able to run to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala anymore. Also, we cannot run to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with conditions. Right? When we run into Allah, we run into Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala according to the conditions that He put. There are five salawat a day. We cannot now say, okay, I'm going to go back to my old habits and combine the salah. I'm going to go back to old habit and skip a Jum'ah, you know, it's okay, I'm safe if I do not skip three Jum'ahs in a row. You know, and we all have these excuses. We cannot run to say, to claim running to Allah with our conditions. Okay? I will run to Allah because, you know, I will run to Allah, but the condition is there are certain things that I have to do and I am doing, and running to Allah is going to be second. Okay, so I'm going to put priority, but this is not going to be first. It is not going to work that way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not accept those who are running to Him with some conditions. No. And we'll learn how to leave these conditions in the month of Ramadan. We'll learn how to run to Allah as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us. You know, we're praying very late because this is the way it is in Taraweeh. Okay? We're fasting up to certain time, that is at the time. There is rules and regulations, a way and a schedule and so forth, and an attitude and etiquette, it all has to be followed. We cannot make our own conditions going to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, number one is running to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and detaching from this dunya, using it, but do not let it use us. Number two, not having any condition running to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No, as the companions did, they came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asking about what the conditions are. They did not wait for the condition to be given to them and the rules to be given to them. Okay? They run to Allah, يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ مَاذَا يُنْفِقُونَ. They ask you about what to spend. They ask about, okay, how do you deal with the money and so forth. They want this way, they want the condition that Allah puts. They are loving to follow those conditions. يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْأَهِلَّةِ. They ask you about the crescent. Okay, why the moon, can we use it to determine what and what and what? Okay? يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْمَحِيضِ. They ask you about the woman's menses and so forth. They're asking for what are the rules and regulations, the etiquette, and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us so you would follow. This is what meaning the second point, that this is what we have in mind. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has for us, and we run and become Muslimin, or become Muslimun, become submitting to Allah. What is Islam? To submit, surrender to Allah. You say, Ya Allah, You are the Creator, we are the creation. You have the You created us, provided for us, and guided us as well. We cannot adjust in the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the third is very important. Running to Allah is not a tool, it is a goal. See, pondering this a little bit. Running to Allah is not a tool, it is a goal. What is the difference? The difference is we want to build a masjid. So let us, what the people that will build a masjid look like? I cannot be without a beard or something, so I'm going to grow a beard now because I'm going to be involved with the masjid. Now I'm using this running to Allah as a tool, right? As a tool, because I'm involved in this now. Okay, I'm coming to the masjid every day, my acquaintances are Muslimin and so forth. So what would a Muslim would say? What would a Muslim look like, right? How my behavior is going to be now because I'm within a Muslim atmosphere, right? If I'm, and on and on. Now I'm going to get married, for example. I'm going to get married to, you know, someone and I need a righteous girl. So what I'm going to do? I'm going to be looking a certain way, acting a certain way so I can get. So my condition and my looks and my behavior are going to look like a person who's running to Allah. But not running to Allah as a goal in itself, but using it to reach something else. Who will be the first one who enter hellfire? The first one who enter hellfire. One who is using running to Allah with the best way of running as a tool. A alim, a knowledgeable person, a scholar. That Allah gave him ilm. Allah tells him, I give you ilm. What did you do with it? He said, "Allamtuhu ya Allah. I taught it to Allah in your way." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Kadabt." You're telling a lie. You taught it so they will say, "A'alim." Qad fa'alta liqala 'alim wa qad qil. You were doing it so they will say, a scholar, and they did say, and enter into hellfire. So his look was a one person who's running to Allah, and the best of runners, right? With the ilm. What is better than the ilm of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of the Quran and Sunnah? But he was using it as a tool. Okay? It's something good to be a alim. So what does it take? You know, it's knowledge. Okay, let us learn this thing so I can sit and talk about it. Now I'm sitting and talking about it. What does alim look like? Okay, it looks this way and that way. Okay, what is the behavior and so forth? So he is playing the role. Okay, and there could be a person who's really benefiting, and people are learning from, and people graduating and doing really good, and people on their way into Jannah. But himself, because he's running to Allah, as a taking the path as a tool for something else. We cannot do that. And we measure this with everything that we do, with everything that we do. That running to Allah is a goal in itself. It is not a step for something else. Okay? We need to purify our niyyah and to renew our niyyah and purify it in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We're running to Allah and Allah alone. And what else in the running of Allah, running to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? We need to learn and know that we're running when you are running, firru, because this is the word, firru, meaning you're moving with power, with strength, with a speed, firru, run, go to Allah. When you run, you're running from something to something. We're running from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's punishment to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's bounty and blessings. Allahumma la manja'a وَلَا مَنْجَى مِنْكَ إِلَّا إِلَيْكَ. Oh Allah, there is no refuge and a place to be protected from you except with you. Right? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala شَدِيدُ الْعِقَابِ. And Allah, also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala غَافِرُ الذَّنْبِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who punishes severely. and the one who also forgives, and the one who gives bounty. So we need to know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is capable over us, and we are running with the hope and fear, both hope and fear, and also running with the trust that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us the reward, will give us what He promised us. We're not running and with doubts. We're not running with doubts, and this is very important. أَنَا عِنْ ظَنِّ عَبْدِي بِي. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hadith al-Qudsi telling us that I am where my servant think of me. Meaning, if you are trying to accomplish something and you in your heart you know it is not going to be accomplished, then it is not going to be accomplished because you don't have trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam give a prescription to those who have sickness, somebody have a headache or something, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tell them that put your hand, okay, in the area that is bothering you and say Bismillah three times. أعوذ بالعزيز القدير من شر ما أجد وأحال. This is the prescription. أعوذ, I seek refuge. من العزيز القدير, from العزيز القدير. Okay? العزيز, the one who has the strength, has capability over everything. Nothing has capability over him. القدير, that the one who is capable over everything. Huh? From, I seek refuge in him from what I fear and what I my complaint or my sickness. Then Allah inshallah will give the cure. That is okay. So now can you say, okay, let me try this? It's not gonna work. Why? Because you say, let me try it. You cannot try Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You cannot try Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You cannot go to Allah and say, let me see if you tell me the truth or not. This is not an attitude to go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Again, run to Allah and know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us what He promises. Those who came early, they are our predecessors. When they talked to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they talked to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as in the future tense, what we're going to do. Right? Here Rasulullah sallam in Mecca, and they're weak. Muslims going all over the place, going to Abyssinia, going to Medina, and scattered all over, being, you know, oppressed and so forth. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam giving glad tidings with the future to come. And you find some companions coming in talking about the future as if it is here. Okay, when that happened to Rasulullah, so what do then? That is the attitude. Not is it really going to happen? No. If Allah promised, it is going to happen. In the meeting, those who came to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam from Medina before the Hijrah, when the Ansar were coming to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to give him al-bay'ah, okay? And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam telling them about the matter that is going to prevail and how Islam is going to be and so forth. Then Rasulullah, one of the companions, now asking of al-Ansar, asking Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so ya Rasulullah, so when that happened, are you going to come to Medina? Are you going to save Medina or are you going to come to Mecca? Do you understand that? Meaning Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's asking Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, something it is going to be. So when that happens now, what is the plan after that? What's going to go on after that? This is an essence of running to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Run to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you know what Allah promised is going to happen. فَفِرُّوا إِلَى اللَّهِ إِنِّي لَكُمْ مِنْهُ نَذِيرٌ مُبِينٌ. I am from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, meaning Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from Allah to you, nadhirun mubin, warning you, a clear warning. So, فَلَا تَجْعَلُوا مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَهًا آخر. So do not take partners with Allah. إِنِّي لَكُمْ مِنْهُ نَذِيرٌ مُبِينٌ. Again, I am from Allah to you as a nadir, a warner, that is a clear warning, a clear warner. Now within this ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the famous ayat that we learn and we repeat all the time. Okay. وَمَا خَلَقَتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ مَا أُرِيدُ مِنْهُمْ مِنْ رِزْقٍ وَمَا أُرِيدُ أَنْ يُطْعِمُونَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الرَّزَّاقُ ذُو الْقُوَّةِ الْمَتِينَ Worship Allah and Allah alone and knows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created you for no purpose whatsoever except one. Except to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what is worship? Worship is a ta'a. Worship is to obey. That is worship. As Imam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah saying, any act that you do, that Allah, any action that you do, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with, is an act of worship. So wherever we are, whatever we do, we are worshiping Allah by obedience to Allah in the aspects of the matter that we are handling. Whatever that matter is. When we're talking to one another and talking in a proper manner, that is a worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because now you're using the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as an example of how to conduct yourself in speech. With the right intention, everything that we do could fall into worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have been worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Ramadan in many, many, many aspects of life. Those sisters and family that have been bringing food into the masjid, this is an act of worship and obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, obedience to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ifshu salam wa ta'imu ta'am. Say assalamu alaikum to one another. After prayer, we come, we will shake hands and hug one another. After every prayer, after Taraweeh, after Tahajjud, and before this and after that, and the food that is coming, and وَطَعِيمُ الطَّعَامُ Say salamu alaykum to one another, and feed one another. All of this is an act of worship. Allah is one. And to know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one, it's a relief. It's a relief. It's a relief that you know that the problems that we have, we can only go to one to solve the force. We know that whatever wishes that we wish for, only one can give us. We only go to Him. We know whatever happens to us, it happens from one. And who is this one? He's the one who is the most knowledgeable, the most capable, the most wise. He has the perfection and the epitome of all the most beautiful attributes and names. So whatever is happening is good. And it's going to go to justice. It's going to go fair to fairness. It's going to go to the best result possible. That is comforting. To know Allah is to be comfortable. To know, get to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make you look good in this life. To run to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a refuge. That when we get there, when do we get there? When we, after death, that is when we arrive. Just a second before death, we did not arrive yet. We don't know how far we are in the distance yet. We're not safe yet. As some companions said, if my right foot is in Jannah already, I might be tested. I might be tested still. But we have that combination. Fear, but hope. And he who has those two before they die, Allah will, according to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them what they hope for and protect them from what they fear. قل قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فضلا من يستغفر
الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين ورحمة الله للعالمين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعه إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، and we cannot not mention our brothers and sisters who are suffering in the world. We are disconnected physically with them, far away and far away distance. But we should never forget that we are one body. As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam described to us, that we are one body. That if one organ of it, one part of it, there is difficulties in it, there's sickness in it, then the rest of the body gets humna wa sahar. It stays up and it gets temperature, gets fever, meaning there is an effect when a part of us is suffering. We know the atrocities that has been happening against Muslims all over the world. Just go to any difficulties that is going on in the world now, you find the Muslims are the one who is being oppressed. We should never disconnect and we think that there are Muslimin here and Muslimun there and there are different Muslimin. No, we are all one body. And we should never think that we are disconnected with one another, meaning that whatever happens to them we're not responsible for. We are. Whatever shortcoming that we have, it can affect us all over. And whatever closeness that we have with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that can affect us all over. The dua that has been given and we've been saying collectively and individually for our brothers and sisters, that is connected with them. We know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is putting us through this, and it is a test for those who are there going through it, and for us also here. What are you doing about it, and are you feeling it? Are you worried about it? Are you correcting yourself here? Are we correcting ourselves in our behavior so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless us and bless Muslims all over the place? You know, Bayt al-Maqdis, it's always been a place where in it either muttaqoon or jabbaroon. Those who are muttaqeen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or all those who are tyrant. When the Muslimin live up to what Islam is, then they will be in it. Once they leave Islam, they will come out of it, and those who will cause problem to them and others will be replaced by them. When the Israelites who were worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, meaning Muslimun, those Muslims who follow Musa alayhi salam, when they finally reached the level of piety that Allah is pleased with, they entered it. And when themselves disobeyed Allah, they left it. And then Musa alayhi salam tell them, go back. They said, no, you go back and you are your word, go back and fight. We're here. Why? Because there are tyrants in there. Again, la ilaha illallah. Wa'alam. And know who's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Know, have the knowledge that there is no God but Allah. There is no deity to be worshipped except Allah. What does that mean? This is what our life is about. And once it is corrected, our life is corrected in this path, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us what Allah promised us in this life and in the hereafter. Allahumma anta a'lamu bima fi qulubina faghfir lana dhunubana. اللهم أنت أعلم بحاجتنا منا فاقضها لنا. اللهم أنت أعلم بسرنا وعلانياتنا فتقبل معذرتنا. اللهم اجعل لنا إيمانا صادقا في قلوبنا حتى نعلم أنه لا يصيبنا إلا ما كتبته لنا ولا ننال إلا ما كتبته. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وقوموا إلى صلاة الله.